My mother would always talk to her children about her grandfather, who was born a slave. His name was Papa Renty. She talked about the fact that he not only learned to read, but he would read to others, that he would read from the Bible to other people. She talked about him as being this larger-than-life type person that everyone respected and revered, particularly in terms of teaching people to read when it was illegal to do so. When I first saw the image of Renty, it was really a surreal experience. I was first amazed at the fact that I was actually seeing for the first time the image of a person that I had heard so much about. There was something about his eyes. I felt like, or as if our eyes connected. There was something about the stare in his eyes that kind of spoke to me. Delia, when I look at her, I feel trauma. I often think about the tear that welled in her eye when she was forced to pose for the daguerreotypes, and what that experience must have been like in terms of affecting her relationship with her father, and understanding the implications of the not only the exploitation but the nudity, the inhumanity. I have been on a journey traveling not only all across this country, but even to different parts of the world, investing in this story. And I do that because I'm driven by two things. Firstly, the promise that I made to my mother to document this story. But I'm also committed because, not only because of my love for my mother and what Papa Renty meant, but now I feel like I'm a part of a larger story about reparations, about ensuring that the descendants of slaves have the same protections as other aggrieved groups. It's now become a story that's bigger than me, I think bigger than Renty. It's a story about finally having an open and honest discussion about slavery and the exploitation of slaves and how people have profited and enjoy that profit and privilege to up until today.